Hello and welcome to this full tutorial and overview of Apple's Pages. If you're looking to master Apple's Pages, be able to utilize every tool and feature that it has, this is the video for you. So Apple's Pages is part of Apple's iWork suite alongside Numbers and Keynote. So think of Numbers as like Excel, and Keynote is the comparison to PowerPoint. So Apple's Pages is like Microsoft Word. So it's a word processor, basically, and it's able to be used on your Mac as well as your iOS devices, and it really encourages the continuity between all of Mac's devices. But we can export and do things that allow it to play nice with Microsoft Word, and we'll talk about that later on in the video. So let's start from the very beginning. When you open up and download Apple's Pages, you can go up in the upper left-hand corner, go to File, New, and you can choose either from a template, as you see here, or we can choose a blank document. So choosing a blank document, if we double click here, will just bring up a blank document for us to begin working with. Now, as far as the user interface goes, what you're going to see at the very top here, this is the toolbar. This is where you'll add images, you'll add charts and tables and text boxes. Everything will be done here in the toolbar. When you add one of those things, like we have here with this text box, you will then be able to bring up the format sidebar or formatting sidebar. So anything we have selected here on our document, like this text box here, we will see the associated format panel on the right-hand side. So for text, this is where we can make it bold, italicize it, give it a color background, and you'll see all of the normal things here within your format panel on the right-hand side. So just keep that in mind as we progress through the tutorial. Anything you add media-wise, text, imagery, charts, tables, select them in your document, and then on the right-hand side is where all of the properties and all of the formatting will happen as far as styling and making it look and feel like you want within your document. If you ever do something you don't want to do, you hit Command-Z on your keyboard, and that will undo your action. So in order to create a new document, you go to File, New, and then go ahead and select whatever document or template you want to use. We'll use this nice little note-taking template that they have available for us here. And then once we do that, if we want to save it, we'll go to File and then go to Save. This will save it as a Pages document. Just remember that. And then go ahead and decide where you want to save it on your Mac. Give it a name. So we'll go ahead and give this Notes as a name here. And then you just click Save. And as you can see here, if we go to our Documents folder where we just saved it, here is the file we just saved. Now, if you right click and go to Get Info, you will see that this is saved as a Pages file. Just know that when you're sending that to people to work on. All right, now let's talk about adding and formatting text. That's going to be the thing that you do most. So if we go to a blank document here, click anywhere in that document, you're going to see your blinking cursor. You can begin typing like we are here. So type away, get your document how you want it. Now, if you wanted to add a text box or a text in a specific area, it would be different than just clicking and, you know, having your cursor. You would want to go to text up here in the toolbox. And this gives you a text box that you can drag around, and you can see kind of our grid areas here to kind of let you know where the center vertically and horizontally is on your document. And you can double click into the text box and start typing your text here. So two different types of text. You have the text that's just the running document text, and then you have the text box that you can adjust and move around a little more freely. And then if I hit backspace or delete on my keyboard, as I've selected that with any element, that will remove it from the document. So again, here's text. Now, in order to format text, you just click and hold and highlight the text like I have here. And then we'll go over to our formatting panel on the right-hand side, as I've already mentioned, and you'll see three different tabs. You'll see style, layout, and more. So under style, very self-explanatory, you can change the font. So we can change the font to be a different type of font. So if we want this to be, say, this Monaco font, we can select that there. Regular or italicized or bold will normally be in this drop-down box. You can change the size of the font by either selecting and typing in the font size that you want to use or using the up and down arrows like so. So again, you can double click here, type in 26, hit enter. And as you can see, it's now 26 point sized font. If you want to bold, italicize, underline, or strike through, you select your text and then bold, italicize, underline, or strike through just like so. Again, hit Command-Z to undo anything that you don't like. Under character styles here, this is where you can see a couple more even more detailed kind of markdown type things like emphasis and red bold and things of that nature. If you want to change the text color, you go here to text color, go ahead and select or click on the color that's currently active, and then just select the color that you want to change it to. As far as placement on the page, you have left, center, and right aligned. If you hit center, it'll center that text in your document here. And then if you notice, if we go ahead and highlight our cursor after that text and hit enter, that will also have the same formatting. And in order to get it back to normal, what you'd want to do is you just want to go to left aligned here, and then you can go ahead and say if you want this to be the body of your document, change that back to 12-point font, go ahead and go over here, and now you can start typing over here, you know, and it's not going to apply the formatting as you see here. And that's really everything you need to know about text. If you want to, you can always go back, select a specific text here, and always format it separately. So if we want to change this back to black font, we can do so after the fact. And then you'll see spacing, like single, double spaced, bullets and lists. You can add bullets by just typing and hitting the dash symbol on your keyboard here, and it'll automatically start the dash. But if you wanted to, you could select a list of things like you see here and go over to our formatting panel under bullets and lists, and go right here and select, say, a bullet like so, and that will automatically bullet those. Now, in order to get rid of that, you hit enter or return twice, and it will stop the bulleting list. That's really everything you need to know about adding and formatting text. Next, let's talk about inserting and editing images. This is where the fun really begins, right? So what you want to do is go to your toolbar here, and you'll see something that says Media. It'll have a little image picture. Click this here, and this will allow you to select from photos, videos, music, image gallery, web video. You can even record audio. So if we go to photos or videos here, this will allow us to select a photo from our photo library or somewhere on our Mac. And then you just go ahead and select it and hit X there. Now, the beauty of photo manipulation here in Pages is we can select that photo, as you can see, and start dragging it where we want it. You can also select the handlebars on the edges there and go ahead and drag in or out to adjust the size. So if we want to click and hold and put this kind of aside where our text is here, we can do that. I believe that Pages allows you much more freedom than even Microsoft Word does. So again, play around with that. Another thing there under Media is going to Media and then Record Audio. So if we hit Record here, it's going to begin to record audio like you see kind of going to the left to right on the bottom of my screen. And then if I hit Stop like so, I can insert like so. And it allows people to go to this document, click that little sound icon, and hear the recording that I just recorded from my microphone. I can select that as I would anything and hit, you know, I can select that and hit backspace to delete it as I would anything. So in order to format the image even more, you select the image, bring up the formatting panel on the right side, and we can do a few things. Under style, we can add a border like so. You can choose the border that you like. You can even add a drop shadow or underline like you see here. You can change the opacity, which makes it obviously more transparent or less. And then you can even add a title and a caption to your image. Under the image tab here, you can replace the image directly from the formatting tab. You can edit a mask. So if we go to mask here, we can change the mask and kind of edit where that image shows up in our frame. I kind of use that as kind of like a frame there. So there's our frame just like so. And then you can obviously always go to, when you have this selected, you can obviously go to arrange and decide where you want that specifically within your document. But I like just going over, clicking and holding and dragging that document like so. Next, let's talk about working with tables and charts. So this is where we get a little more technical. So if I want to add another page to my project here, I would just go up to the upper left-hand corner and click on Add a Page to this document. I can scroll down, and that adds page number 2 to my document, giving me a clean slate to work with. Now, in order to add a table, you'll go to your toolbox here or toolbar and go to Table. And then it's a really cool kind of feature where you can just select how you want your formatting to look. So if we go here, we'll do this little green color like so, giving the top, you know, green color as a shade. And then as we go down, it kind of alternates between a lighter and darker tint. If we want to add a row, we click the little lines here and we hit the up arrow to add and the down arrow to subtract. Same thing goes for columns. Go over to these lines here and hit the up arrow to add, and you want to add the, and then click the down arrow to remove. So in order to add data to our table, we just select the cell that we want to add it to, and it should show as highlighted here. And then we can go here and add different text by just going ahead and starting our typing. And in order to move to the next cell to the right, you hit tab. That takes you there. Or you can use your arrow keys on your keyboard, like you see me doing here, to navigate to a specific cell. You can always format how the text looks by going and highlighting a specific column like I have here. And if you want that to be, as you see here in my formatting tab, I can go here and change kind of how that is arranged. So if I go to the text tab here, I can hit center aligned, and that aligns that text to be center of the cells. I can go here and select multiple rows and columns, and then go ahead and hit the center option there to make it look a little better and clean it up. Now, when working with charts, it's kind of backwards. So if we go up to chart in our toolbar here, and then we add, say, a bar chart, as you see here, is you go ahead and just click into edit chart data, and then you go ahead and here is your table here. So table, as far as chart data, is always going to be linked to the chart that you create. So create your chart first, then you go ahead and go to edit data. It brings up the data or table panel here, and this is where you can go and you can add different regions. So say region 3, you can see as we add the data, it goes ahead and adds that to our chart. Now with anything within pages, if we click and hold here, we can adjust and drag this wherever we want it. Same thing goes for our table here. We can click and hold this little icon here to move our table and our charts around. And that's really everything I wanted to show you in terms of charts and tables. The last thing will just be shapes. If you go up here to our toolbar, go to shapes, we can select from a number of shapes and objects and geometry objects, but the basic ones are arrows and squares and rectangles and things of that nature. You can click into a shape and add it. As you can see, you can drag that around your document as normal. The formatting panel will come available on the right-hand side. Under the styling here, you change the color, obviously. Under text, if there wants to be text underneath it, play around with the formatting tab here to kind of play around with your shapes. Again, clicking and holding the handlebars here will allow you to, drag and rotate the shape. Just remember, when you do drag, it will go ahead and be disproportionate from normal unless you hold down the shift key and drag that way, and then it will go ahead and make sure the shape doesn't get warped in any way. So that's working with shapes. Now let's talk about utilizing templates and styles. So if we go up here and go to File, New, as shown earlier, there are a number of templates. There's reports, books, letters, and many, many more. So if we go to, say, a resume template and then go ahead and double click on the one we want to use, this gives us a good baseline of what we're working with. So we're going to go ahead and hit allow. And as you can see, here is the template for a resume. So we can go in here and fill out our information like you see here. But again, working with templates are fun because once you're done with this and you format it the way that you want it, you can always go here and file, as you see here, and you can save that as your own document from the template. So again, I'll get out of this one, show you again, File, New, go to your templates here, choose one that you want to use, say a party invitation, and then you can edit the template like you see me doing here. So I can edit this template like so, make it look the way that I want, and then when I'm ready, I can always go and export and save. Next is going to be collaboration and sharing. So let's talk about collaboration and sharing first. So if we go back over to our main document that we started with earlier, if we click on the share option here, we can save this to the cloud within our iCloud feature here. And if we do that, we will then be able to see over on the right-hand side here, people commenting on it. So we can add a comment within our toolbar here, and you can see that I can say, this is wrong, and then go ahead and click done, and it's going to show up as a little highlight here. I can click on that, and I can see the comment that it brings up and who it's from, right? So that's kind of where the comment is there. And then when you share that, other people will be able to comment as well. So a very cool collaboration features within Pages. Now let's talk about exporting. This is a big one. So we have our document here, we go to File, and then we go to Export To. There are a number of different formats that you can export to. You have PDF, you have Word, which will allow people on PC to open it in Word. You have EPUB, plain text, RTF, imagery, Pages 09. We want to save this as a Word. So we'll save it as a Word doc, as you can see here. And you can even select whether or not you want to require a password, or you can just save it as a normal PDF. But if we save it as a Word doc and we go to save here, and we're going to go ahead and save this on our desktop as untitled. Now, if we go to our Finder and then go to where that's saved, as you can see here, and go to Get Info, you're going to see that it is saved with an extension .docx. This is probably what you're going to want to save most of your documents into. And the reason being is because you can send this back and forth between anyone. whether they're using Apple, Mac, or whatever. DocX is more of a general extension that allows people, and it plays much nicer with outside of Mac-type software. So just understanding saving that in the Word file format will do that, but you can always go up to File and then go ahead and export to a PDF and save it as a PDF as well. So that's everything you need to know about exporting. Now let's talk about printing. If you want to print, you go to File and then go to Print right here. And then you have to make sure you have a printer that is added to your Mac or connected to your Mac. But then you can select, do you want to print all the pages? Do you want to print just a range? Everything will be done here. And then hit print, and that'll print your document. That is everything you need to know about Apple's Pages. If there was something I didn't cover that you wanted me to, put that in the comment section below. Like and subscribe if this helped you. Like this video if it helped you at all. And don't forget to subscribe for more tech tutorials like this. And I'll see you guys in the next video.